Is it on? I'm not getting any signal. Is it on? I'm not getting any signal.
Hello.
Woo.
There it went. Back off again.
And there it went.
Okay.
And then it died again.
Off again. It's on that end.
Hello. Okay.
Seems to be working.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the 2016-2017 school year. I think I speak for a lot of people, certainly all of our teachers and staff, in saying we are so glad that you are here. We are so glad that you're here. What I want you to do is I want you to stand up and I want you to give three high fives to somebody not sitting right next to you. And just upgraded chapel venue and worship experience. Seniors will be happy to know we've got these extra speakers right here just for y'all, so there's not going to be this void where you're not going to get the sound right at you. So it's really a beautiful thing. And so it's really nice to be back. And I'd like to welcome all of our new students here. If you are a new student to Trinity, we are so glad that you're here. I don't want to embarrass you or anything, but I would like you to stand up.
Oh, yeah.
Just want to stand here.
Let's see. Thanks.
Stay standing. audience, this is not everybody else. We're going to give them a 2 clap. You know how to do the 2 clap? Okay? So, on me, we're going to give them 2 claps. Ready, go. 2 claps. And again. Pretty good. Nice job. You guys can have a seat. Welcome, new students. We also have some new teachers and staff here in the building that we want to get you guys to know. And so if you're a new teacher, new staff member, new administrator, would you please come up to the front? Please come up to the front. Come on up. Let's give him a hand. Let's give him a hand.
That's you.
That's you.
That's you.
To you. So listen up.
I'm Coach Smith. All y'all mostly know me. I teach now. I am in 8th grade history.
Alright, I'm Coach Gutierrez. I'll be teaching history and economics. And I'm excited about being here at Trinity. And I want to give a shout out to my friend over there, Brandon Gilbert.
My name is Mrs. Fansler, or I'm high school cheer coach, so I'm Coach Fansler to them, so I answer to them. 7th grade math, I have an 8th grade math class also, and then of course, cheer coach. So this is the look I have all the time.
Guys, I'm Mr. Koskamp, or Coach Koskamp. If you're an 8th grade boy, I'm coaching 8th grade boys basketball and junior Bible this year. And I'm happy to be at Trinity.
I am Mrs. Fuchtrell, and I am your new assistant principal. Yeah. And I just wanted to share something. I was a Trinity student, and I was sitting where you guys were sitting all throughout junior high and high school. And the quick fun fact for today. Today marks the 20th anniversary of the first time that we had classes in this building. And I was sitting where you guys were sitting as a freshman. I did a junior high over there at the Canton campus. So that's just a fun fact for today. And those of y'all who've been around, y'all might want to check that fact which one, right? But I'm pretty sure that was good. But it's good to be here. It's good to be back at Trinity. And I can't wait to meet all of you.
Hey y'all, I'm Shady. I don't know what I go by. I don't go by Mr. Small, that's my dad. You can call me, I don't know, we'll work on that. I'm teaching 8th grade Bible, or attempting to teach 8th grade Bible. And I gotta save all my good stuff for when I preach, so I'm not gonna tell y'all anything, so.
Take a look around. Guys, I want us to show our appreciation for our teachers. And they are going to pour their lives into you this year. They've been praying for you. We've been here for a couple weeks getting ready for you guys to get here. And I know they're all excited to have you all here. And these are incredible men and women who are dedicated to Kingdom education, to discipling you, to pouring their heart and their lives into you. And they are going to give you everything that they have this year. And I just want to start by thanking them in the beginning. I want to give them a standing O. You guys know how to do a standing O? Standing O. So we're going to stand up, and you're going to make, hang on, I'll show you. You're going to stand up, you're going to make an O. And you're going to do, give them an O. Okay? You're going to stand up. Stand up. Talk about some things that you guys need to know, okay? And what I'm going to do is I want you to, with somebody nearby, probably next to you is going to be best, I want you to decide, one of you is going to be, you're going to pick a partner, one of you is going to be an A in your partnership, and the other person is going to be a B. So you just look around, find somebody, decide who your partner is going to be, an A or a B. Share with a partner, and when we do partner sharing, you're going to share, it's going to be really loud, but then you're going to know it's time to stop sharing and pay attention back up here when you hear this song. Forward to about this year at Trinity. Go! Discussion times, and we're going to come back to that same song, okay? So be prepared. One of the things I want to do this morning is I want to go over a couple things that you need to know, some new policies and procedures, okay? And since you guys have been gone this summer, we've been working really hard, and we've been working with the administrators, the teachers, and your SEC. If you are an SEC, would you please stand? Please stand. Student Executive Council. SEC has been really instrumental in kind of helping us give some student focus group research and feedback on how we can better create our policies that are going to be best for you in the school. So we're going to talk about those, and there's been some changes since you've been gone, okay? Since you've been gone, I can breathe for the first time. So moving on, yeah. Thanks to you, now I get what I want. Since you've been gone. Chapel has a tendency to go long, like people this morning. And so that will run into our flex period, which we'll talk about here in a second. We will be taking class time, and we'll have lunch. We're all going to have lunch together, and I'll explain that here in a second, and then third and fourth period. Okay? This will give us the flexibility to keep the schedule pretty much the same throughout the year, and also do things that we need to do during that chapel time as well as the flex time. Does that make sense? Okay? Also, on occasional Fridays and Mondays, you guys are going to have a half day. Two Mondays and two Fridays throughout the year, we're going to do our staff development on Friday or Monday afternoons. So you may have noticed Wednesday's schedule is the same as every other day now. We don't have a special Wednesday schedule that's shorter and confusing. Every day of the week is the same, okay? And when we have those half days, you're still gonna have all four of your classes, like it shows there on the right, but they're just gonna be a little bit shorter, okay? Does that make sense? Next thing I wanna talk about, you may have been wondering about this flex period, the flex period, okay? And this is kind of the new name that we're calling study hall. And until, well, let's just say for the immediate future, we're gonna have it just like a study hall. So you're gonna go to your study hall teacher, or your flex teacher, but you're gonna just have a regular study hall like we usually do, okay? And then, following high school retreat, for the high school students, we're going to give you a little bit of flexibility as to whether or not you go to study hall or you have some chill time in the commons, okay? And so some of you are gonna say, wow, I really need my study hall. So I'm gonna go to a subject-specific study hall. Some of you are gonna say, you know what? I just need a break. I just need to chill a little bit. And so I just wanna hang out with my friends. So you're gonna be able to go to the commons, okay? This flex time, once we get there, is gonna be a privilege that can be revoked. So we'll talk about that more a little bit specifically once we get to high school retreat. Generally speaking, during that flex time, leadership development training is going to be on Tuesdays. Class officer meeting is going to be on Wednesdays during that time. Thursday is still going to be reserved on occasion for clubs during that flex period. Latin club, Spanish club, chess club, etc. Okay? So that's a little bit what you need to know. As far as junior high goes, you guys are going to have, your flex time is going to be a study hall throughout the year. Okay? You guys don't get academic study halls yet. You will when you get to high school, so you want to make sure that you have that time to get your homework done, okay? And so more to come about that flex period, okay? Next thing I want to talk about is we really want to improve communication. And so we're going to have, if you go to the next slide, we're going to have an all-school texting group, an all-school Remind 101 texting group, okay? And so, this is how you're going to be able to join it. I don't want you to do it right now. We're going to put this information, this slide, out in the commons and other screens around the school so that you'll be able to get on that texting group. But we really want to be able to communicate with you all a lot more effectively, and texting is the way to go. I know a lot of your class sponsors have a Remind group, your coaches, your teachers have their own Remind group, so you may be on three or four of these. But this is going to be the all junior high, high school Remind texting group. And we think it's going to help you. Let's say, for example, there's something we want to let you know that's going to be happening. Like, we're not going to have our regular flex time on Monday. We'll let you know that so that you can plan accordingly. Okay? So we're going to try and let you know so there's not surprises when you get to school in the morning. Okay? New cell phone policy. Is that up there? Okay? So it's not really that new, but guess what? We're going to really try and enforce it a little bit better than we did last year, okay? So junior high students, you guys can have your phones in your backpack, but they must remain turned off until the end of the day. Must remain turned off, so they're not going to be with you on your person throughout the school day. If you need to call somebody, go to the office, okay? That's the best way to handle that. High school students, we're gonna really ask you if you're gonna be on your phones before school, during lunch, and after school, okay? Unless a teacher gives you permission to use your cell phone in class for some educational purpose, okay? Most of your teachers, when you go to class, they're probably gonna have a place for you to put your phones anyway. But they're not gonna be out in passing periods, not gonna be on your phones when you're walking from class to class, okay? That's gonna be grounds. If you have your phone out, we're gonna take them up. Okay, so before school, during lunch, and after school. Pretty clear on that, okay? This is a learning environment. This is why we have this rule, okay? Cell phones, for the most part, are a distraction. We want to make sure that we limit those distractions, and we can make sure that the learning environment is preserved as much as possible, okay? So that's our goal with this cell phone policy, okay? So what I'd like A's to do, if you're an A, I'd like you to teach this cell phone policy to your B partner. Go. Is because we realize that you need, your brain needs fuel. Okay? Okay. Okay. Now, we're asking you to use wisdom with this, and the teacher in that particular classroom has discretion on how that's going to go in his or her classroom. Okay? We're asking you if you want to bring a small snack that's not going to be distracting. Okay? You're not going to bring your whole lunch into class. Okay? Protein bar, granola bar, something like that. And if you bring a drink, we're asking that you bring a drink with a lid so we're not going to spill. Okay? We recommend water. If you want to drink some caffeine, coffee, something like that, that's fine. We really do not want to see a lot of energy drinks, like Red Bull, stuff like that. This stuff is just bad for you. Not wise to drink anything. Okay? So, the key with this is that this is going to work as long as the learning environment of the classroom is not interrupted and disrupted, and that we're not leaving the classrooms a mess. Okay? So we're putting a little bit of the responsibility on you to make wise decisions here. Use this policy appropriately. Okay? If it doesn't work, then we can always change it and adjust accordingly. Last thing I want to talk about is lunchroom procedures. Lunchroom procedures. You may have noticed that our new art rooms that are being built in the dungeon area are not quite ready. Okay? Our goal is to eventually move those art rooms into the new art rooms, and where those art rooms were over there is going to be a brand spanking new lunchroom. And you're going to eat on the tile there, not on the carpet. We're not quite there yet, okay? So for now, this is how it's going to operate. 7th through 10th grade are going to be in the lunchroom together, and junior high is going to be released at noon, so they have an opportunity to get through the line and get there first. That's 5 minutes before everybody else is going to be released. Okay? And 11th grade, you guys are going to be eating lunch in the commons. Okay? Same with 12th grade, unless you have off-campus lunch, which you can have today if you turn in your form, your off-campus release form. If you haven't turned that in, you're eating lunch in the commons today. Okay? A couple things here. Do not turn left on the University Avenue ever if you're a student. Okay? We can go out here. You can go out behind the Dairy Queen. We're not going to make that left turn. If we see you doing it, your off-campus lunch privileges are revoked. Okay? We're not going to have lunch in classrooms. Okay? That's not going to happen. Okay? By the way, with this new eating policy, we're not going to have people going to the vending machines during class or in passing periods and turning up late for class. That's not going to happen either. Okay? So if you want to bring a snack, that's fine. We're not going to be going to the vending machines during class to get snacks. Okay? Oh, and by the way, the administrative team is going to be covering lunch duty. Yeah, how awesome is that? We're pumped about it. Okay? So we'll be in there hanging out with you guys during lunch. Okay? So, bees, I want you to teach this lunchroom procedure, because you guys are going to do it here in a couple minutes. To the A's, go. Teach them. Go. Do you not know that those who run in a race all run, but only one receives the prize? Run in such a way that you may win. Starting a new race this year, it's a new year, and I want you guys to know that y'all have a fresh start. Don't know really what happened last year, what happened this summer, but you got a new race to run. And I want to encourage you not to run it alone. I want to encourage you to run it together, to rely on each other. I want to encourage you to run it with your parents, your family members, your siblings. I know some of you have siblings at this school. I want to encourage you to run it with your coaches and your teachers, because they're right there willing to give you a hand. And most importantly, I want to encourage you to run it with God, your Father, in heaven. I want to show you this brief clip to illustrate this point. Go. Thank you. a shame. I wanted to give you a visual aid about how much your God in heaven, God your Father, loves you. And this is a story from the Olympics. I hope you guys have been watching the Olympics. It's been really great to watch, hasn't it?
Oh, it may be working now.
Okay, maybe we're going to get it. Came up to his son, he said, "Son, you don't have to do this." And he said, "Yes, I do, Dad. I need to do this." And he said, "Okay, let's do it together." And they finished together, and everybody was like, "No, you can't do that." And Dad was like, "No way, you're not giving me my son." Right? That's how much your God in heaven loves you. That's how much God wants a relationship with you this year. And I want to encourage you to allow that to happen and not try and win the race alone. Okay? Let's close in prayer. God, we love you so much, God, and we thank you that you are a good, good Father. God, we thank you for the start to this new school year. I thank you for every person in this room, God, that is part of our Trinity family. We thank you that it's by your sovereign will that you have appointed us all to be here for this time and this place and this year. And God, we declare that this is going to be the best year that Trinity Christian School has ever seen. God, we ask for your help. We can't do it on our own. Help us run the race. Help us run it together. Help us run it with each other. God, help us run it with you by our side, lifting us up, encouraging us, picking us up along the way, helping us finish the race, Lord. God, we ask your blessing upon our day, upon our year, God. We ask that your Holy Spirit would fill this place and that we would give you glory in all that we do. God, we just are waiting with expectancy for an incredible year. God, I ask that you would just fill the hearts and minds of all of our students, that that's what you have for them this year. That it's going to be a better year, a greater year than they can even possibly imagine. Help us be a family. Help us be united. Help us be all in this together. Help us give you glory with our lives. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay.